Jumdi Absol. Hello everyone. This is Virginia Tatch and I welcome you back on another video on our VOKK TV series to rediscovering and preserving the Khmer Krom identity. On November 10th, 2020, the Khmer Krom around the world shared disturbing news on social media about a video clip posted by a Khmer Krom man, Sok Khon Kim, asking the Vietnamese government and the world for help to find justice for his family. The incident happened at the sub-village 9, Ward 9, Prettrapang, Tra Nhung City. I watched the video shared by Mr. Sok Khon and saw that his house had a front gate that had access to the main road, which was just a short distance away. An individual found in the video claimed to be the landowner in front of Mr. Sok's house and wanted to forbid Mr. Sok's family to access the main road via his front gate. However, Mr. Sok's family had been using it for years. With revelation coming from this video, Mr. Sok Khon's family wouldn't have built the house that he and his family are living in with the gate facing the main road if he knew that they were not allowed to use the land in front of his house to access the main road. Because the landowner comes from a wealthy background and with connection to the high-rank government officers, the Tra Nhung court allowed the individual to build a wall to block Mr. Sok Khon's house's front gate from accessing the main road. As the indigenous people of the Mekong Delta, the Khmer Krom people have faced so many injustice land disputes, even if the land rights are the fundamental rights enshrined in the UN DRIP, United Nations Declarations on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. Even if Vietnam signed to adopt the UNDRIP, Vietnam continues to technically deny the indigenous people's existence in Vietnam to avoid implementing the UN DRIP. It is recorded that in 2007, Vietnam had signed to adopt Article 25 and 26 of the UN DRIP, with the article stated as follows. Article 25, end quote, Indigenous peoples have the right to maintain and strengthen their distinctive spiritual relationship with their traditionally owned or otherwise occupied and used lands, territories, waters, and coastal seas and other resources, and to uphold their responsibilities to future generations in this regard. Now, Article 26, number 1. Indigenous peoples have the right to the lands, territories, and resources which they have traditionally owned, occupied, or otherwise used or acquired. Number 2. Indigenous peoples have the right to own, use, develop, and control the lands, territories, and resources that they possess by reason of traditional ownership or other traditional occupation or use, as well as those which they have otherwise acquired. Number 3. States shall give legal recognition and protection to these lands, territories, and resources. Such recognition shall be conducted with due respect to the customs, traditions, and land tenure systems of the indigenous peoples concerned. Let us look at the land rights that Vietnam have been the root cause of so many injustice cases of land rights abuse. The government does not resolve it peacefully and cannot seek justice for the victims. According to Article 4 about the land ownership of the latest reformed land rights in 2013, end quote, land belongs to the entire people with the state acting as the owner's representative and uniformly managing land. The state shall grant land use rights to land users in accordance with this law. Even this law was so-called reformed in 2013. However, it still carries on the communist ideology about the people's ownership and state management. Because of the Article 4, the people in Vietnam have the rights to use the land, and the government has the right to decide to whom the government will give the land. This controversial law causes so many land-grabbing corruptions and pushing thousands of families living in poverty because of losing their farmlands. Let me give some well-known land disputed cases that the Khmer Grom people have faced throughout the Mekong Delta. Let me start with the case of the Khmer Grom farmers in Mat Truk, Chau Dak province. Between 1978 and 1979, during the conflicts between the Communist Vietnam and Democratic of the Cambodia peoples, the Vietnamese government used various strategies to force the Khmer Grom residing in Mat Truk, Chau Dak province to evacuate and resettle in Klang, Sok Trang, and Po Liu, Bat Liu provinces. The Khmer Grom people were ordered to leave behind their belongings such as farmland, homes, properties, and livestock to live in the new economic zone with no irrigation system, no sanitation, and limited access to basic food and medicine supplies. In 1981, the Vietnamese government started allowing the Khmer Grom evacuees to return to their former towns in Mat Truk. They then discovered that the Vietnamese people had already taken up residence in their houses, properties, and farmlands. Their local Buddhist temples were looted, and many precious paintings and carvings were lost and or destroyed. The Khmer Grom in Mat Truk has demanded the Vietnamese government to return their confiscated farmlands since 1981. Instead of helping to return the seized farmlands to the Khmer Grom, the Vietnamese government has threatened to imprison them. When Vietnam starts allowing the people to file complaints about their confiscated farmlands beginning from 2007, the Khmer Grom in Mat Truk filed complaints. Still, the Vietnamese authority refused to resolve it. The Khmer Grom people started organizing many peaceful protests, and unfortunately, the authority responded by using armed forces to physically punish them. Mr. Chau Hen was arrested and imprisoned for 2 years because of leading the protest to demand returning his confiscated farmlands. The confiscated farmlands of the people in Mat Truk province still are not resolved until this day. In Klang, Sok Trang province, Mr. Win Ba, a Khmer Grom land rights activist, led the Khmer Grom farmers from Sok Trang province to demand returning their confiscated farmlands many times at the ethnic minority agency in Kan Tho province. Although the representatives of the ethnic minority agency have no power to resolve any issues. Because Mr. Win Ba was the leader, he was arrested on May 30, 2009 and released in February 2011 without a free and fair trial. He had no lawyer or rights to defend in front of the Vietnamese court. As of today, the confiscated farmlands of the Khmer Grom farmers in Klang province have not been returned. In Phetrapang, Tra Ying province, on April 22, 2010, Mrs. Tran Thi Chau was arrested and later sentenced by the court of Tra Ying for 2.5 years in prison. Mrs. Tran Thi Chau had a land grab dispute with the local authorities at the Ni Chung Market in Ni Chung Village, Cao Ngang District, Tra Ying province. The authorities arrested her and then accused her of the alleged crime of retaking her land. As of now, her land grab dispute has not been resolved. In Gromon Sol, Kienyang province, on May 8, 2020, the Vietnamese authority of Tra Pot Commune, Phu Mai Village, Giang Tan District, Kienyang province sent hundreds of their police forces armed with guns, electric batons, and tear gas to brutally attack 46 Khmer Grom farmers who were farming on their confiscated farmlands. On June 7, 2020, Mr. Win Van Dep was arrested and detained for 3 months. The Vietnamese authority will bring him and other three Khmer Grom farmers, Mr. Tien Dam, Mr. Tien Nam, and Mrs. T. Bick, to face court with the alleged crime of, in quote, restricting a law enforcement officer in performance of his or her official duties. Vietnam now allows these Khmer Grom farmers to hire lawyers to defend them in court. Still, I want to see if Vietnam enables the lawyers to protect their clients based on Vietnam law freely or not. As farmers in the Mekong Delta, the Kamaigaon peoples live based on farming. Their lands are the only way they make their living. Because Vietnam's land law doesn't allow the people to have private ownership, the government wants to grab the Kamaigaon farmland. The government can use millions of reasons to take it, and the Kamaigaon will never win in front of the Vietnamese court. I would like to end this video by reminding the Vietnamese government, if the Vietnamese government insists on carrying on the communist ideology into the land law using the rhetoric of people's ownership and state management, the land dispute due to corruption or whatever the reasons may be, it will never be resolved, and that would lead to social unrest. Som ok, chom tiep lia. Thank you.